my lecture, I would like to tell you something. That is, today is the great day to learn something new things. Once again, I repeat, today is the great day to learn something new. So right now, we are going to learn the new topic. Maybe it's you are aware of it, but still, I would like to continue with this topic, that is tenses. I know everybody knows about these tenses, but still, once again, yeah. So all are with me. So today we are going to learn tenses. Before I would write on the board, I would like to tell you what is tenses. Like tenses is used for what? Tenses indicates our time. It indicates our time and whatever sentence structure or whatever you speak, it like tells you that this sentence or the action is done is which time? Is it present tense or past or future? Yeah, whether right now I am having an interaction with you. So from my sentence, you will come to know whether I am having a right now present tense or I am talking about the past tense or am I talking about future tense. So, and one more thing, why we are learning these tenses? Because it's an English language. As you know very well, English is really a very important language. So you should know the grammar rules. And in that, the one grammar rule is tenses. So let's begin. Tenses. So this is the tenses. And you know, there are three types of tenses: present tense, past tense, future tense. First one, why we are focusing on first one, that is present tense? Any idea? The first one is present tense. We give importance to present tense. Why? I will just write it down here, present tense. And do you know why we are giving more focus on present tense? Because present is the time which we have the power to do something, right? Now we have this power, the action, whatever action I am doing, right now I can do it. So that's why we give more importance to present tense. See, even though any tenses, the first comes present tense. Because right now, I have the power. Right now, I want to go to Mumbai. So right now, I have that power. So it's a present tense. Second tense is past tense. This is the past tense. Past tense, we talk about some actions which have already over. The actions which are over, that we talk about past tense. So like interactions, communications, we ask what happened that day. So in that communications, in that language, in that sentences, we need past tense. Let's go for future tense. Future tense, as I told you earlier, present tense, this is the tense which we have the power to do something. Past tense, the actions which we have already done and we think about it. Future tense, in future, we hope, we have that hope that I want to do like this, I will do this. That is future tense. So here there are present tense, past tense, future tense. You know very well, but still. Okay. So in these tenses also, in each tense, there are four types of tenses. In each tense, that in present tense, in past tense, in future tense, there are four types of tenses. First one, simple present tense. The first comes simple present tense. Same in past tense also, the first type is simple past tense. Same thing in future tense also, simple future tense. Second one, progressive, continuous. Present continuous tense. Present continuous. Same thing in past tense also, past continuous tense. Same thing in future tense also, future. switch off continuous steps. We can say continuous progressive also. Progressive is also continuous. Both are same. Continuous or progressive. Present progressive or present continuous. Okay. So here you can see present continuous, past continuous, future continuous. Third one. I think so everyone can see third one. So here is present perfect tense. Present perfect. Here we have past perfect. Same thing in future also we have future perfect. So everyone can see this. So there are one more type is there, that is present perfect continuous tense. Same thing in past tense, past perfect continuous tense. Same thing future, future perfect continuous tense. If I will write much down, you can't see. So that's why I have it put here. Okay. So these are the tense. So tenses, there are three types of tenses: present tense, past tense, future tense. In present tense, we have four types. That is, first is simple present tense. Second is present continuous tense. Fourth is present perfect continuous. Present perfect continuous. Same thing in past also. Past perfect continuous. I will just give a dot. Past perfect continuous tense. Same thing. Future perfect continuous tense. And we will go one by one, and we will also learn each tense or each type of tense is which sentence structure we are using or what type of sentence structure we should use in each tense. So all are with me. Let me just erase this. Tenses we are going to learn right now so that you will understand easily that in each tense what makes so much difference. Yeah. In simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Right. First of all, we will begin with simple present tense. Everyone can see. Before I give you the formula of simple present tense, I would like to tell when we use simple present tense. We use simple present tense, the actions which we are doing every day. For example, the actions like brush our teeth, taking a bath, whatever, habit actions like exercise, doing exercise, having a breakfast, going to school, going to work. These all actions which we do every day. Exceptions are different, like holidays you don't go. It's okay because Sunday is holiday or in between any holidays are there. It is fine. But the actions which we do every day, that is habitual actions, that will come under simple present tense. Universal truth like sun rises in the east, sun sets in the west. Universal truth, honesty is the best policy. Universal truth, always respect your parents or your teachers. Universal truth. So, sorry. That will come under simple present tense. So once again, I would say, in simple present tense, the actions which we do every day, the actions what we are doing every day. Okay. But now, for example, if I say I brush my teeth. So right now, I am brushing my teeth. I brush my teeth. So whenever I wake up, I brush my teeth. So this is the sentence you should. This is the sentence structure you should take for the habitual actions and universal truth. For example, first I will write the formula. Okay, so you can see here, and I will write here formula. The rule, the formula of this, that is, first should be subject plus V1. I will tell you about the V1. In bracket will come S/ES. Okay, I don't have space, so that's why I have to write here plus object. So here subject plus V1 S/ES plus object. Now I will write it. You can see V1. Now what is V1? V1 is a verb form, and what we say verb is a base form. Verb base form. Now what is verb? Verb, of course, it's an action word. Verb is what? Action word. So V1 is a verb base form. And why I have used S or ES? So there should be a subject, V1 plus object. Now I will tell you the importance of this. Why I have written here S and ES? Okay. So here I will give a mark. Can I see from here? If the singular subject means only one person or one thing, that is singular subject. One person, one thing, that is singular subject. For singular subject, the verb one will take S or ES. The verb one will take S or ES. For example, eats, drinks, sits. See, the S will take. Now about ES. Now you will ask me about ES. So where will take ES? Now for example, fixes. So singular subject, V1, S, ES, V. So what about plural subject? I will just erase this. Okay. So I will erase this. Plural subject. Only V1. That means no S or ES. Only V1. Singular subject in V1, S, ES, plural subject only V1. So according to this formula, subject plus V1 plus object, so I will give both examples. First one, Sita likes, I will write likes. Sita likes chocolate. So here you can see subject Sita. Subject V1, and because the Sita is singular subject, I have used S likes and object chocolates. So this is the singular subject. Now here one more example. They do exercise. Daily. Now everyone can see here, they, subject, but it's a plural subject, they, right? V1. Now here there is no AS, so I have used only two. Exercise. What they do? Exercise D. So are you getting the formula and when we use simple present tense? Are you getting? So have you understood that when we have to use simple present tense? Now I will tell you about the simple past tense. Look this better. So first one formula. I will not write formula because it will confuse you. Okay. Here the formula will be subject plus V2 plus object. Subject plus V2 plus object. Now, then we have to use past simple past tense. Before that, now V1 is used for base form. V1 is used for base form. Now V2 is the past form. V2 is the past form. Past form of the verb. V2 is the past form of the verb. Right? So here subject plus V2 plus object. Now before that, before I continue with all the examples, when we have to use simple past tense. Simple past tense is used when you are informing or telling that simply the action done in past. Okay, you are not specifying any time. You can specify any time, but simply you can also say that action is completed. Only you are saying that my action is completed. Then at that situation you use simple past tense. But in addition, if you want to say a particular time or fixed time, it's okay. There is no mistake anymore. But when you want to say, when you go according to the formula, it represents or it says that the action right now, like action completed. Something action, for example, I completed my homework. So I am not specifying the time, which time I have completed, but my work is completed. I finished my food. So you're not specifying the time because you also don't know what time you have completed. Only you know that the action is completed. So that time we use simple past tense. As I have given the subject, now here for singular and plural subject, both it is used same. There is no ES, S, no D. The past is for same, all. So I would like to give you examples. For example, so for subject, Rahul completed his homework. Rahul completed his homework. Rahul singular subject, still it is completed. Now I will give you the example of plural subject. Plural subject like yes, Rahul plus, sorry, not plus, Rahul and Priya. Now this becomes a plural subject. Rahul and Priya, same, completed. There, now here should be there. Okay, possessive pronoun, there, homework. Here comes the possessive words, possessive adjective. Okay, this comes the possessive adjective. So Rahul and Priya is a plural subject, and still the verb is same for singular and for plural subject. The verb is same, and then there. So this, see here, I not specified what time the Rahul completed. Only the work is complete. So when you're telling simply the work is completed, there you use simple past. So let's be switched to simple future tense. Same here. So before writing formula, once again I will write that when we use simple future tense. Simple future tense, you are constructing your sentences like the action which you are doing in future or which you will do in future. So there also, maybe you can specify the time or you cannot specify. It's up to you. In some sentences, you can specify. In some sentences, some sentences, if you not specify the specific time, it's also no issues. Only I will complete my work. So simple future tense, the action which you will do in future, but not a specific time is there. Okay. So here formula. Subject plus your will or will shall is compulsory. Okay. Will or shall plus here comes V1 and that object I will write down plus object. Here I will write down. This is the formula of simple future tense, subject plus will shall plus V1 plus object. Now once again back to V1, and V1 is what? Verb base form. V1 is the verb base form. So here I will give you some more examples. Here also no need of S and ES. For simple present tense we used S and ES. Here no need. It is simple. So, example. Okay, we will use this. So, it will be comfortable for you how to use it. So, now here also. See, Rahul completed his homework. It means he didn't mention the specific time. Only he is saying that he has completed his homework. Now, same thing we will do in future tense. Rahul will complete his homework. So, you will understand easily. Rahul will complete his homework. Rahul will complete his homework. See you. So see, I can say tomorrow, I can say at 5 o'clock, I can say in the evening. It's additional information. But if I say Rahul will complete his homework is also correct because this sentence will come in the simple future tense. Okay. Additional information you can give. But if you have it done, Rahul will complete his homework is well and good. So, second example. So now you can guess what will come. Rahul and Priya will complete. Will complete their homework. Okay, Rahul and Priya will complete their homework. Now everybody can see here, say here also. Rahul is singular subject, but still the verb will go as it is, will complete. Same thing if the plural subject. If the sentence is a plural subject, still it will go, will complete. Now you will ask me where to use shall. As I have given in the formula shall, where we have to use shall. See, the shall word has become very uncommon. Most of the time people use will. So if you don't know exactly where to use shall and will, so you just go with the will. I will, they will, you will. Grammatically it is not, it is correct. But if you are offering something, especially if you are offering also, you can use will also, but when you are offering, so may I open a door for you, or may I bring water for you, I am offering. So I can use shall I bring a water for you, shall I open the door for you, is also correct. Then, if you use will I open the door for you, will I bring a cup of water for you, is still, it's okay. Grammatically it is not correct. In that sentences, offering, if you're offering, shall gives a more emphasis in that. Right. So, hope so. You have understood. Simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense. Right. So, once again, I will give a short summary of simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Hope so everybody has understood. And the next tenses. Next formula of tenses, I will explain in my next video. Hope so everybody is fine. Now it's the time of COVID-19, so take care, wear mask and enjoy your life ahead. Sanitize yourself. If you are going outside, when you are coming at home, sanitize your hands, your legs, Wash your hands, face, everything. Keep clean. You are clean. Your family is clean, clean and safe. And your family is safe. Definitely the entire world is safe. So bye.